Hello again, everyone! Today we're gonna be finally playing Five Nights at Freddy's VR. Yes, I said I wasn't gonna do it because Scott gave the game to, like, everybody else super early. See, Taco is still over there playing it, and he got the game like 2 weeks ago.
Oi, guys, Scott gave me this game. Things about to get interesting.
Yeah, you see, it screwed me. But anyway, here we go. Where's my headset?
Surprise, I'm back.
Oh my god, does anybody remember this guy? This is Master Albert Kendo, the cringy Minecraft-playing 9-year-old who stays perpetually 9 years old. He was on the channel in, like, 2013 and 2014. What are you doing with my headset?
Yeah, so, we're gonna play this game, Five Nights at Freddy's VR. And so right when I put on the HTC Vive, it looks like...
What? What just happened? Okay, whatever you're seeing in there can't be that scary. Let me have this. Let's see what he's seeing in here. Oh my god! Quick, get it off! Start the scribble knots! Hello again. Do you want to learn how to create, of course, the FNAF VR helpy from the menu, as well as what I used to call V-Rabbit or Glitch Bunny and all that stuff? It apparently is called Glitch Trap right now. This thing seriously has had like 17 names. FNAF fans gotta get this in order. Ladies and gentlemen, here in Scribble Knots Unlimited, where we create your favorite characters, of course, usually just based on whatever's the most popular, most requested. A lot of people really like seeing that speed create that we did with helpy. This was like a week or two ago, and so I'm gonna go ahead and start off with the dancer as the source object so that we can also create the Glitch Trap VR bunny. You know what I'm talking about, right? Wait, this would be spoiler, but the game's been out long enough and it's just like everywhere. I feel like people know about this thing. We just had a golem back thigh piece or whatever to put down there on the stomach. There's like that belly that it's got that's a different lighter shade. So there has been actually a render of this character that is without the glitchness. It looks like if you saw this thing without all the ghostliness. We're gonna go down with a star from space, of course, and that's actually going on a bear. There's the back leg piece behind or whatever, the thigh of the bear. That's like for the vest and whatnot. Bow tie for the bow tie, of course. We put down P as well as BB for those buttons down there below the bow tie. Again with that golem back thigh piece right here for the legs. And this is actually interesting. A lot of the times when we're creating these animatronics just over the years, you know, I have some like 60 episodes of FNAF creations on this channel because you guys know how many games are there. Well, creating the feet were so different this time, and that's good. I think we first of all need to evolve a little bit, but also each animatronic, while some, I guess, would have similarities between each other, there is some differences like this, and the feet really look different, so we went with webbed feet. And then I just used Jenny Greenteeth, the back arm piece, for both of the arms. So there was a while there where I was just calling this Glitch Bunny Virtua Spring Bonnie, because I was looking at the official fandom wiki page, and now they seem to have updated it yet again to show that the name is Glitch Trap. I don't know if this is gonna be the final name or what, but we're gonna have a little bit more spoilers and things, so just get ready from that. I'm actually gonna read from there, but Glitch Trap, of course, they're listing as the main antagonist in Five Nights at Freddy's VR Help Wanted that exists within the Freddy Fazbear virtual experience. I'm seeing here also they say that he appears to be a virtual manifestation of William Afton, as shown from his behavior in-game. So once again, if he wasn't all glowy and looking all glitch-like, then it would seem to be like a golden yellow color, but we're going more with this off-green yellow with the eyes glowing really bright pink, and you can still see the pupils in there a little bit. So I definitely just wanted that to be known, that was the design that we were going with there. And so you saw that we created the body of the character, but didn't have a head on there, right? Well, that's because Scribble Knots Unlimited, if you're not familiar, it does have a stamp limit, meaning you can only place down a certain number of pieces to create your character overall. We're gonna go with Shark right here with the head as the source object. This is a way to get past that stamp limitation, you know, so we can have more pieces to construct our character overall. And so I'm going with a flying fish bottom fin right there. Good shape for the mouth if you take two of them. And we do have that split down the middle, which is okay to have in this case, just because it's like just right below the nose, there is like a slight line or whatever that can be pronounced, I guess, between the nose and the mouth. Troglodyte back arm piece going up here to finish out that muzzle area of the Glitch Trap pearl. And so the pearl I'm going to take for the eyes. And again, we're going to kind of do this really glowing eye. So not as much detail in the eyes, but you can still see, especially if you zoom in or brighten up the image, that Glitch Trap does seem to have like eyelids up on top of the eyes, but really thin, and then possibly eyelashes or whatever on that. I went with wart as the pupils, but for that kind of eyelash, eyelid look, we just took a cobia and took the fin of that, gave it the zebra print pattern, because we are going to run out of stamp space if I don't conserve somewhere, so that's going to be one good place for it. Troglodyte back arm piece again. That was for the start of the ear. That's to our right. Of course, that's Glitch Trap's left ear. And then an angel. If you take the back arm of the male angel, you can actually use that for the top of the ears on both sides. And you can do it for the inner ear part as well, that lighter shade. Golem back shoulder piece for another lighter shade in there. Gonna have to call this Glitch Trap head. Anytime that you do have a head and a body separately, though, you do want to make sure in the scripting tool or in the properties editor, go to the equipment tab on the left side. It's down below. And then fill in the circle that says can be worn on the face like glasses. It's kind of what you need your scripting there for. And so we would run out of stamp space if we were to continue doing more of these, but you can use a cat tail, the actual tail of a cat, as the whiskers on Glitch Trap. But again, you would run out if you don't eliminate something. So I just eliminated some of that lighter yellowy green shade that was within the ears, the upper ear parts, and all of that. But ladies and gentlemen, let's take one 30-second break right here to acknowledge our sponsor.
There is no sponsor. We're gonna sponsor ourselves. You know that you want Dr. Kendall merch. I mean, you could get a t-shirt. It's all in the Teespring link integration. Or, don't you want one of those? Those are the paintings that we did in the past part two videos. You could get one to put up on your wall.
Thank you. Back to the creation. We're going to start off with a rectangle as the source object, and this is actually, again, reiterating what we did in the speed create version, I guess, of our FNAF VR Helpy. And so this is going to be Helpy as seen when you just select kind of that FNAF, original FNAF 1 universe from VR Help Wanted. And so we've got a lot of stamps going down. It was a speed create earlier, and this time we're going to go a little bit slower, but we still need to keep pace here. Ostrich egg for the body as well as the belly on the body. Golden egg starting off the arm over there, as well as a Mola's body piece, and then pebble many times for the hand and the fingers on that hand. A beauty, the female beauty back arm piece. We had duct tape kind of for that desk that Helpy is sitting at, and minus sign can be the button that he's pushing on. Of course, an F. We're going to type in FNAF for FNAF. That's going to be on the menu. After this hatchet fish fin piece, I went with a sword and just painted that black. You turn it upside down, and it kind of can be sort of a, I would say, a creative way to get the tie, as well as just some more detail to the character overall. So after you get those letters of FNAF, you can also type in carrot, that's C-A-R-E-T for the little up arrow. That'll be the arrows on both sides of the screen, of course. So this is, again, Helpy as seen from that screen. And so this is something kind of new for us in this Scribblenaut series. You know, we don't often create the characters in that way. You know, we create them to be like humans or humanoids walking around, or creatures, animatronics, things like that, walking around on screen. But this one's just going to be a stationary object. And so to get the head, again, we definitely ran out of stamp space, and so we're gonna need it for this head object right here. It's actually starting off with the glue as the source object, and the glue we can use literally like glue to attach it to that menu screen rectangle source object that we did earlier. Schnitzel just went down. Alien torso or body piece was for the main shape of the head. Golden egg for the start of those eyes. We haven't yet put the eyes in there. Bubble for the ears. A hat for the hat. Dots are gonna be several times. They're gonna be a little bit for the eyes, but also for those pink cheeks. A nursery fish, there's like a side fin sort of near its head, really small looking piece. You can blow it up a little bit and paint it black for the nose. And we had Mahi Mahi, the side fin as well. That's a good stamp for the eyebrows. And let's go with spider fish right now. We can put that down sort of where the mouth is supposed to be. Do two of them though and paint them black. And you just saw that we had more dots. We had all that stuff glue as well for the white of the eyes. That all kind of comprises the eyes. And we had a dayfly, the back tail piece. Actually, that's going to be the stamp limit. We just put down the bubbles for the ears. So that's good. We had enough stamps just for this. But that dayfly piece was pretty nice to have for the teeth. You know, you just kind of want them to have like that buck tooth look right there. Looking good, ladies and gentlemen. So of course, just to attach the two, you take that head object, just like glue, you can place it exactly where it's supposed to go. So that's going to be different from our Glitch Trap. When you take the head of Glitch Trap, you know, you're going to want to basically put that head into the hands of the body object, and then it's going to go, wow, that's actually very rare that the head kind of goes exactly where it needs to go. Usually you need to do some kind of editing to the body object and change the grids around if the head needs to go lower or higher. But this fits. Hallelujah.
There's our remake of Bonnie. You know, we've talked a lot about Bonnie in the past and created so many different versions and everything. Sometimes you guys have seen, though, this Bonnie show up in things, and we've never actually created it in a creation episode. It's very similar, though, to our design of Glitch Trap here. They're gonna take forever to fight, so let's leave them to that. And ladies and gentlemen, please consider subscribing if you haven't. Check out the playlist that's gonna be in the end screen pretty soon, as well as maybe another video. So I'll catch you guys over there.
And thanks for viewing.
Down the road of twists and turns, always anxious to see what's within. We can look ahead to the point of no return, to the rest of our lives, to the spectacle.